London and Toronto listed Caledonia Mining has got its assets in Zimbabwe, and that by many is perceived as the main risk here. We've got a company which is expanding production, it's cutting its cost base, and it's also seeing a growing dividend. Let's talk now to the Vice President of Investor Relations, Mark Learmonth, who joins us. Mark, welcome.
Morning.
I was listening to a presentation of yours just a week or two ago, and you were saying basically we're just continuing to do more of the same, just churning out.
It's not just more of the same, it's because that would imply no growth and costs stay the same. So we are we're continuing to increase our production. So 44,000 this year, 48 next year, 52 the year after. Our costs are low, and we'd expect that they would either stay at these low levels of $554 an ounce, or potentially as we increase production, might just reduce a little bit further. So it's not so much we're standing still, but we are continuing to entrench ourselves as a growing, low-cost African producer. But I mean, the significant thing that's come out in the last week or so is, our continued focus on paying money back to shareholders by way of a dividend. So in April this year, April 2013, we paid a 5-cent a share dividend in respect to 2012. And what we announced just a week or so ago is a 20% increase on that from 5 cents to 6 cents, which we're now going to pay quarterly. So that means every quarter from January 2014 onwards, every quarter, we're going to be out there reminding shareholders that we're still in business. The dividend is still well covered in terms of the cash flow, the cash in the bank, and our earnings. And hopefully over time, we would expect the shareholder base, well, not existing shareholders, but also new investors, to begin to recognize the fundamental strength of this business, notwithstanding the two issues we face, being the fact we're in Zimbabwe, which is less of an issue than it was, but it's still an issue, and the increasing headwind we're getting from being a gold producer, which has only emerged really in the last 6 months or so.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of small companies here at Mines and Money are talking about the difficulties they face, but not very many are in your position of being able to produce in lower costs. But I mean, how difficult is this compared to last year, for example? I mean, if you look at your share price, one wonders why it's fallen so far.
Well, the share price has fallen a lot less far than most other junior gold producers. So we're down slightly year on year. But if you compare us to the GDXJ, which is an ETF of other small gold producers, we've significantly outperformed that year to date. And if you add on the dividend payments that we made, that outperformance is increased. But sure, the business is better positioned than it was now than it was a year ago, but our share price is down, and that reflects really quite severe market fundamentals for junior gold producers, particularly those who need to raise money. We're not in that camp, but we all get painted with the same brush.
You are also expanding the resource, aren't you?
Yeah, over the last...
A blanket.
Yeah, the blanket. Yeah. Over the last 4 years or so, we've done not a lot in terms of resource development, but there were very good reasons for that. Over the last six to nine months, we've increased the focus on resource development. We've taken on five new exploration geologists at the Blanket Mine in Zimbabwe, and we're budgeting for a much more aggressive drilling campaign at Blanket with a view to increasing our reserve and resource base and giving the market better visibility or increased confidence as to the longevity and the long legs that this business has. That is something, but it is going to take quite some time for that to sort of flow through, because we do the drilling from underground. To drill from surface on these greenstone properties is expensive and technically quite challenging. So we are drilling from underground, which takes a little bit longer. But over time, we should be seeing the news coming out about the intersections. And in due course, I can't quantify the time frame, things like new 43-101s.
So what's for 2014? And I mean, also put expected production in 2014 in the context of what we saw this year.
Well, this year we'll see 44,000. Next year we'll see 48,000. It's only a 10% increase or so, but 10% increase helps in terms of boosting the top line revenue. Also helps to keep the costs under control. So depending on where the gold price goes, it should allow profitability to stay stable, potentially even increase a bit if the gold price doesn't fall too far. But given the fact that the dividend we're paying is almost six times covered by cash flow and earnings, it makes that dividend very stable, very secure, and it gives us the flexibility, if we choose to consider further increases in the dividend. Because by doing it quarterly, it means we've got much more ability to calibrate the dividend rather than just whacking out something every year, every half year. It gives us much more ability to finesse things.
Okay, so the message?
The message is watch for steady increases in production, depending on the gold price, steady increases in profitability, but stability. So we don't want any adverse shocks. We want to get people comfortable with the fact that this business is here, is successful, it's here to stay, and investors should not be unduly cautious about putting their hard-earned money into what is perceived to be a high-risk mining venture in a high-risk jurisdiction. We believe we've pretty much de-risked that, and it's just a question of getting investors comfortable with the appreciation of those risks.
Okay, Mark, it's a pleasure again. Thanks for joining us at Mines and Money.
Thank you.
Mark Learmonth there from Caledonia Mining.